स्टार्टिंग विद नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर कोऑर्डिनेशन कंपाउंड्स, कलर इन कोऑर्डिनेशन कंपाउंड्स. नॉर्मली दीज कोऑर्डिनेशन कॉम्प्लेक्सेस आर कलर्ड, दे शो वाइड रेंज ऑफ कलर्स. इट शोज कलर व्हेन व्हाइट लाइट पासिंग थ्रू इट इज पार्टली एब्जॉर्ब्ड एंड पार्टली reflected. The color shown is the complementary color generated from the wavelength present in the reflected light. This color is due to d-d transition of metal electrons. Now what is this d-d transition? You can very well understand in crystal field splitting, you have seen the splitting of d orbitals. So d-d transition means jumping of electrons from lower d orbital to higher energy d orbital. Now this d-d transition is possible only in when the ligands are present, means in only in case of coordinate complexes. You can see this complex, this is vacant, violent in color. This complex is violent in color. But in the absence of ligands, crystal field splitting will not take place. Hence, the substance will be colorless. Means, if this compound, from this compound, you remove water on heating, then it becomes colorless. Here is the color chart, which shows the complementary color. If this is the absorbed color, this will be the observed color. If yellow is absorbed, you will get violet color, green is absorbed, you get red color, and vice versa. Limitations of crystal field theory. In crystal field theories, in short, we will write as CFT. Only d electrons of metal ions are considered. But what about the electrons, s orbitals, p orbitals? They are not taken into consideration. Second, this theory considers metal ligand bond purely ionic. It has not considered the covalent character. Third, it cannot explain the relative strengths of ligand as given in spectrochemical series. Means it cannot explain why water is a stronger ligand as compared to OH or why CN is a stronger ligand. It cannot explain. It has also not considered the pi bonding in complexes. Pi bonding may also be there between metal to ligand or ligand to metal. So CFT had not considered that. This theory has no significance to the orbits of the ligands. Therefore, it cannot explain any property related to ligand orbitals and their interaction with metal orbitals. Doesn't explain the effect of pi bond on crystal field splitting energy. Now the compounds in which metal is in zero oxidation state and ligand is neutral, they can't be having any electrostatic attraction. Then those complexes cannot be explained by CFT. Next we have bonding in metal carbonyls. What are metal carbonyls? These are homolactive carbonyls. The ligands will only be CO carbonyl group. These are formed by most of the transition metals. These are simple, wave and well-defined structures. You can see the example, nickel tetracarbonyl, manganese compound, then cobalt carbonyls, chromium carbonyls and Fe iron carbonyl. Bonding is very important. How bonding takes place here? The metal carbon bond in metal carbonyls possess both sigma and pi character. How is sigma bond formed? It is formed by donation of lone pair of electrons of carbonyl carbon into vacant orbital of metal. It is very simple. Donation of lone pair of electrons of ligand to vacant orbitals of metal. And now What about pi bond? It is formed by donation of a pair of electrons from filled d orbital of metal. Remember, filled d orbital of metal to vacant antibonding pi star orbital of CO. This metal to ligand bonding creates a synergic effect. It strengthens the bond between CO and metal. You can see here, sigma bonding takes place by donation of lone pair of electrons from carbon of CO to metal. And pi bonding is created by donation of electrons from metal. These are the filled d orbitals of metal to vacant antibonding orbitals of carbon monoxide. This is called back bonding. This is called synergic bonding. You can see here synergic bonding. So this is sigma bond and opposite is pi bond. Now, the last topic of this chapter, importance and applications of coordination compounds. First is estimation of hard water. Hardness, you know, is due to the presence of calcium and magnesium ions in it. EDTA forms stable complexes with both of them, which can be estimated to calculate hardness of water by titration. Coordination compounds are used as catalysts in many industrial processes. For example, this complex, the name of this is Wilkinson catalyst. It is used for hydrogenation of alkenes. Then electroplating. Electroplating of silver and gold can be done very smoothly and evenly if you take their complexes. Medicinal chemistry. Many coordination compounds are used as medicines. There is a growing interest in the use of chelate therapy in medicinal chemistry. Example is in the treatment of problems caused by presence of metals in the toxic proportions in plant or animal systems. Means excess of copper and iron are removed by the chelating ligands, that is via formation of coordination compounds. EDTA is also used in treatment of lead poison. Similarly, the coordination compound of platinum, namely cisplatin, is used in the treatment of tumors. Photography. In black and white photography, though this is not done nowadays, the developed film is fixed by washing with hyposolution, which dissolves the undecomposed silver bromide to a complex. Thank you. This is all for this chapter now.